Hello, this is Chef John from foodwishes.com with frozen Zabaglione. That's right, if you like regular Zabaglione, you will absolutely love the frozen version. If that is, you're getting a real frozen Zabaglione and not simply an ice cream flavored with a little bit of Marsala wine, which is unfortunately what most of the recipes out there are. And above and beyond the flavor, you're about to see what might be the best way to make ice cream without a machine. And I know, I said this wasn't ice cream, but you know what I mean. So with that, let's go ahead and get started. With 6 large egg yolks in a metal mixing bowl, to which we will add the tiniest pinch of salt, right, just a little hint. And then we're also going to need some white sugar, as well as the star of the show, some Marsala wine. And by the way, I'm using the regular dry style, and not the sweet Marsala, since I actually think that makes this come out too sweet. And then what we're going to do is set our heat to medium-low, and we're going to cook this whisking constantly until it becomes hot to the touch and thickens up beautifully. And by the way, doing this directly over the flame is by far the most dangerous and riskiest, but also the most fun and fastest method. But if you don't think you can handle that much excitement, you could, if you want, use the more traditional method of doing this over a double boiler, which simply means to set this bowl over a saucepan of simmering water. But as long as your flame is not too high, and you don't let your towel catch on fire, I think this method works out just fine, and I'd say it's probably the best way to go. But anyway, you decide. I mean, you are, after all, the Pauline Chinfoni of your frozen Zabaglione. By the way, that was my mother's maiden name, and she would have absolutely loved this stuff. But no matter what method we're using, we're going to keep cooking and whisking until this gets very, very thick and reaches what we call the ribbon stage, where if we drip some of the mixture off our whisk onto the surface, those ribbons stay visible for at least a few seconds, which, in case you're keeping score at home, took me about 10 minutes. And then what we'll do once we think our egg mixture's cooked long enough is remove that from the heat and let it cool down completely, which is most efficiently done by placing this and whisking it over some ice water. But if you're saving your ice for cocktails, you could just let this cool down on the counter, giving it the occasional whisk. But the point is, let it cool down completely before you add the whipped cream, which is the next step. So to a cold mixing bowl, we will add 1 cup of heavy cream, and we will whisk that until we achieve soft peaks. And the colder your cream, as well as your equipment, the faster and easier this is going to happen. So it's not a bad idea to actually put your bowl and whisk in the fridge before you do this, especially if you're doing it on a day like I am, when it's like 90 degrees. And that's it. Once we've achieved nice soft peaks, we'll go ahead and take a spatula and transfer that into our egg and Marsala custard, and we will gently fold that all together until it is just barely combined. In fact, 97% combines even better, because as we transfer this into whatever we're going to freeze it in, that will take care of that last 3% of mixing. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is don't overmix this, as we want to retain as much of that air in the mixture as possible. Right, just because those bubbles are microscopic does not mean they can't pop. So do not overwork this. And then once that's set, we'll transfer it into some kind of freezer-friendly container, which, as you probably can see, I did freeze ahead of time to minimize any potential melting. And then I like to lay a piece of plastic over the surface before covering this and freezing it for at least 4 or 5 hours, although overnight's probably better. And that's it, I think you know the rest. We will go ahead and serve that up, hopefully with lots of fresh seasonal fruit. Oh, and apologies to time travelers from the 1980s for me not garnishing this with a sprig of mint. Okay, this needs nothing else. And that, my friends, if you're a Zabaglione lover, or any kind of lover, that is going to be one memorable dessert experience. And quite often, frozen desserts that aren't made with a machine can have sort of a weird crystallized icy texture, but not here. This stuff is incredibly smooth and creamy on the palate, so I really do think you're going to be impressed with the texture. And then there's the taste, which, because we did not use too much cream, is very, very Zabaglione-like, and not like most of the other recipes for this, which really tastes more like a plain vanilla ice cream with a little bit of Marsala in it. But having said that, if you want something slightly less intensely flavored, you could double the cream, or split the difference and use 1.5 cups. And everything else will work out just the same. Oh, and speaking of Marsala, one thing that makes this dessert so interesting and unique is the fact that most people don't sit around drinking Marsala wine on a regular basis. And if they do, probably not for long. So what happens when people dig into this is they can't quite place what the flavor is. Okay, it's kind of familiar, but nothing pops into your brain instantly, like if you were eating something that was strawberry or chocolate or coffee or vanilla, etc. So other than the incredible texture and fantastic taste, which pairs perfectly with fresh fruit, That's probably my favorite part of serving this dessert. Confusing my guests, especially the ones that have never had Zabaglione. Oh, and one last thing before I sign off. I kind of hope you use a dry Marsala, but this technique will work with any dessert wine, quote unquote. All right, something like a Sauterne, or I know some people even use Prosecco. But anyway, whether you make this as shown or tweak this to your taste, I really do hope you give it a try soon. So please follow the links below for the ingredient amounts, a printable written recipe, and much more info as usual. And as always, enjoy.